Alright guys, it's a wicked shot back again here with another video, and in today's audit, I am coming from Kennett License Bureau. I'll be exercising my right to take photo and videos in public places, and I'll see if these guys respect my right to record today. It won't be a long video. If you guys don't like non-confrontational video, too bad. If it's like that, it's like that. You know, we'll see how it goes. So yeah, stay tuned. I'll be going inside, and you know, some of it will be business, some of it will just be me chilling and recording. So we'll see how they deal with that. We'll show you, give you a look around. So right there, getting a license bureau. Yeah, so that's it. Go in, see what happens.
Yeah, we'll call the family. We don't have a PO
box,
so you see.
PO box 43.
And that is carpet.
Yeah.
I want to check on my vehicle and see if I have my wife added to it as a TOD. Is that what they call it?
Yeah, come over here. You said you're having it added as a TOD?
Yeah.
Do you have the title for it?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. I think I have her on one, but I'm not sure if I have her on both of them as
Okay, hang on just 1 second. Okay, so you
want
to make sure she's on
the phone. Yeah, you need my license, right?
Yeah. That's probably easier for me to pull you up that way.
I tell you what, I appreciate your cordial demeanor.
No problem.
You know, I like to give what I'm given, so you really
right.
See that.
I'm the same way. I want to treat everybody the way they want to be treated.
Exactly.
Okay, so 2010 Dodge?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so on the 12 Dodge, it looks like she may be on there with you as owner, which is just as good as a TOD.
Oh, it is?
What's
okay.
Her first name?
Twin?
Yes, okay. So then let's check and see if she's on this other one. Yeah, because that works as the same way.
Oh, it does
TOD.
As a TOD? Okay.
Like if something happens to you, it immediately goes to her. Something happens to her, it really goes to you.
Okay, cool.
And then, yes, sir. They
she's on both? Yes. Awesome, awesome.
So
no,
you are double covered.
No, I can't get her off my back.
Did you we always like to make sure everything's in order.
Exactly, yes, exactly. Yes. All right, I thank you a lot.
Have
and
a great day,
you
sir.
Too, you
thank
too.
You.
Oh, can I ask you a question off the record?
Yeah,
on lunch now, right?
Yeah.
Sorry to waste your 2 minutes. So part of what I was doing, I'm not sure if you heard of it, but it's called a First Amendment audit. You ever heard of that?
Not really.
Okay,
yeah.
So it's pretty much a bunch of guys, they're called auditors. They go around public facility like police station, courthouse, anything that's public.
Yeah.
And they just record.
Yeah.
So typically, it usually have a mixed reaction. Some people, they just see the camera and they're like curious, hey, what are you doing? Are you recording? And some, they just ignore it.
Yeah.
So my style is I like to let the cat out of the bag first.
Yeah.
So that I know if the guys above know, then if the customer start to get a little bit antsy, they'll already know and tell them, hey, it's okay, it's just recording. It's his right. And then, but typically what gets the views is the negative reaction. People see
yeah,
it and they're like,
I have seen stuff like
you
that
see
on
it, right?
YouTube. You
okay,
know?
Yeah, so yeah. It's like, it's everywhere. It's getting more popular now.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to see what kind of reaction I get in my area if
yeah.
people are aware of those stuff or if it's just like what I'll see on there. So because I didn't want to just come in and sit, and I just look weird just sitting there, even though
yeah.
I could, I'm like, I want to legitimize what I'm doing. So let me go, because it's still legitimate. I needed to know.
Right.
So, but that kind of helped. It's the same way I go to the post office. I stand there and record, but I also buy stamps.
Right.
Because, you know, because you're still supporting
right.
what you're doing in a different way on top of that. So
yeah.
I was just, you know, the reason why I'm even telling you is because your aura kind of made me feel more forthcoming, you know what I'm saying?
Good.
So typically if people are like a little bit, you know, you can feel energy, right?
Yeah, yes,
so if the energy feels weird, I'll just like, I won't even waste my time trying to explain to them and tell them what I'm doing.
Yeah.
So that it quells, because it's crazy. Most people react more terrifying seeing somebody with a camera than somebody with a gun. My thing is, the guys that do it professionally, they do it for the interaction. Me, I do it for the for
watch
the
door, sweetie, they're fixing
it coming. For educational purposes, because not a lot of people are aware that, hey, you know, you got rights, right? You got your first one, which is what I'm doing, and you have the second one, right, to be your arm.
Yeah.
So because these two are the ones that matters the most to me, the first and the second, that's how I show my support for just going and record.
Right.
But only on public, because you can't, your right stops right there. Only at public. If you go on somebody's private property, they can.
Right, then it becomes invasion. The legality.
So I did it at the PD.
Yeah.
When it went crazy good, I was surprised how good it went, because typically the cops' interaction are the one people love the most.
Yeah.
Because they're like, oh, cops are gonna beat you up. They don't know the law.
They're
pretty aware of it. It's like, we know about the First Amendment, so you know we won't mess with you.
Oh no.
And then where did I go after? I went over there. That went good too. But 99%, one person wasn't having it. Even though it was just like, she was like, I don't want to be in camera.
Right.
And I'm like, dude, if you work in the public,
everybody sees you anyway.
Everybody sees it anyway. You're being recorded. It's like one of the things that it's like they don't really comprehend it. Like, wait, if you're in public, people can record you in public. It's like, but it's private. I'm like, no. If you don't want to be in camera, you got to work in the private sector.
Yeah.
You know, but she was like just one person, but everybody else, even though they didn't even know what was happening at the time, they didn't bother me.
Right.
And then I went to the post office, was the same, the workers know. Even the post office, they have a sign.
Yeah.
It's like the rule and regulation at the post office. And and there's a section on there that even tells people, hey, it's okay to record if you want to. And what people forget is that they're on camera at least 70 times a day before you get home.
Right.
So what's the difference if somebody...
There's no difference whatsoever.
No difference.
And we have at least 10 cameras in there.
Exactly.
That record everybody to make sure nothing happens.
Exactly.
If something does happen, there's a, you know, record of it.
Yeah. And what people forget, when you tell them that, when you tell them that, they're on cameras everywhere, they're like, oh, but these are secure. I'm like, no.
Right, no.
You can access those cameras if you want, because it's public. You know, you can force, hey, I want to check the camera anywhere, whether it's a public station, and like, oh, I didn't know
the
that.
The only place you can is in private property.
Exactly.
So
I'm still surprised. I only have one more place to try that, and it's the library. The library is public, right? That one is public?
Yes,
okay, I wasn't sure.
Yeah, right down there from the post office. They sure are.
Okay, so that's going to be my last stop, because I did I'm only trying to do the public places.
Yeah.
And then I think that's the last one and I'm done. But just because it was so kind and respectful and you didn't freak out.
Southern ladies, we don't really like to be on camera unless we're fixed up. You know?
Yeah.
But I don't care.
Yeah.
I learned a long time ago, if I care what people thought how I look, then I'm in trouble.
Exactly. I'm the same. I'm like the lead. Photogenic type of person.
Right.
I hate being on camera, so I know exactly where. And on top of that, I'm very awkwardly social.
Yeah.
So I'm doing something that I don't even typically do, because it requires me talking to people.
Right.
But I'm trying to get out of that comfort zone.
Yeah, you push yourself a little bit, and you'll realize.
And it I've been really happy with the ways, because you get to know people and talk to them and. You build up more respect for those guys, like you said, that keep the country running. That's kind of the other reason as well. I want people to see, hey, these guys on the front line that keep your stuff
keep
going.
Moving.
You need to see these people and respect them, especially the ones that respect your right, you know, so.
Yeah, no, I'm all about rights. I mean, you have the right to do and say whatever you want. As long as you put hands on me,
next,
we're
that's
good.
Right, that's right. You know, most people, even when it comes down to, especially that one, the right to say whatever you want, you'd be like, oh, but it hurt my feeling. I'm like, well.
That's your feeling.
Exactly.
They'll heal.
Exactly, You learn.
Nobody is going to like everything you say.
Right. If feelings was more important than rights, then cops would be going around arresting people for feelings.
And I think that that's the biggest thing, is that everybody's more worried about their feelings being hurt than they're actually understanding where somebody else is coming
from. Exactly. Yeah. That's what I said to the cop when I was in, like, hey, you guys remember, you're law enforcement, not feelings. If somebody says they're uncomfortable with the camera, don't come mess with them, because you have to, if they're not breaking the law, you can't mess with them. And it's like, yeah, we know that.
Yeah.
You know, typically people call on them, say, hey, there's a guy recording, and he's like, he's allowed to. What do you want with it?
Right.
And then they're like, oh, you can't do anything.
No.
Yep.
And I see those all the time. I watch them on YouTube.
You watch them? Yeah. Good.
I watch them all the time.
Awesome.
Like in a park, and some lady's like, so you can't be in this park.
Yep.
Like, you don't own it.
It's exactly.
Park. For some reason, it's the... Even though I don't want to get the negative interaction on mine, right. I like watching those, because it's kind of, I guess.
Seeing how people act.
Yeah, and it makes it feel awkward. I'm like, man, they're just, you know what, they can't just be nice and honest. Right. Especially when the guys are being open and trying to explain to them, and some of them still react
it
nasty.
Feels,
yep, it's like
some people just like to be miserable.
Exactly. I can tell, man, your energy must spread throughout the whole building. I could sense it. I was glad you're the one that come. I'm like, please, I felt that energy. Let me get over here.
Anytime, sweetie.
No problem.
Well, I appreciate what you're doing.
Hey, thank you.
Day.
You too. Yeah. Just got done with the audit at the DMV, and it went pretty good. I'd give them a pass, you know. You know, that lady at the front that I spoke to, I liked her energy, so that's why I was willing to be forthcoming with her. They didn't know what I was doing. Because I return, I give what's given to me. So, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. And for those of you that are just looking for a negative reaction, you know, and that's why you tune into my videos, well, keep looking. Because if you find it, you find it. If you don't, you don't. That's not what I'm about on this channel. I'll just show what's, you know, what's there, you know. I'm not going to try to make anybody do anything that they don't want to do. You know, if they do it, they do it on their own. So, this is Mr. Wicked Shot. Signing off to you guys. Peace.